Recently, I've been dipping my toes into all things mechanical, and it is inevitable because if you make something electrical, you have to make the PCB, you have to even sometimes make the custom footprint or create a housing for it. And I made a lot of mistakes because I'm not from a mechanical background. And that's why for today's video, we are gonna create a footprint for a tiny, tiny module, which is absolutely non-standard. We cannot find the mechanical dimensions in a typical footprint library. And I'm also gonna share on how to avoid some kind of novice mistakes. So for the purpose of demo, we are going to create a completely new KiCad project, and that's the tool of choice that I'll be using. Now we're going to be using this footprint editor, so let's open that up. The first thing we note about the KiCad footprint editor is that we have a list of all the library items here, which means that not every footprint must be started from scratch. For example, the other day I had to create a USB footprint, and I was basically going through all of those, and I found that something like this is what was pretty similar to what I wanted. For the purpose of today, we are going to be using this tiny, tiny little module. And if I kind of flip it over, this is how it looks like. It's really tiny. It can fit in the palm of my hand. And it is basically the GPS or GNSS patch antenna module that comes from CD Top. So as you can see, it's nothing really found in the library, anything similar to this footprint. So that's why I'm going to create a footprint from scratch. So if we come to Preferences and then Manage Footprint Libraries, and if I go to Project Specific Libraries, you will see that it is completely empty as of now because I haven't created any library. So let me open up the footprint editor once again. And now we are going to add a new footprint library. So inside the example, let me just call it, say, GPS.pretty, and I'm going to put it under project. So now when I search for GPS, there you see the library is right there. So let me create a new footprint right here, and I'll simply call it PA1010D. So there you see the footprint is now created. Of course, there's nothing inside because we are going to make the footprint from scratch. Interestingly, when we come to Preferences and then Manage Footprint Libraries, and now when we go to the Project Specific Libraries, notice how the library path and the name for the footprint is already automatically populated. So this is where we will start making the footprint right from the scratch. And the number one tip that I have is always, always refer to the data sheet, especially for non-standard footprints such as the one that I will be making. There is typically a section called mechanical drawing or a mechanical dimension or PCB layout inside the data sheet that we should be looking for. So for example, this is the data sheet for the module that we will be looking into, and under Section 2.1, we see mechanical dimension, so let's go right there. And there you see it will be a recommended PCB pad layout, which will have the exact dimensions that we can refer when making our footprint. All right, so now that we have actually found the data sheet with the precise measurements of the footprint, the next thing I would say is never, ever, ever use the grid or move anything manually. Always use the placement. So let's settle the measurement unit first. So we will go back to the KiCad and ensure that millimeter is chosen because that's what the data sheet says. Secondly, you see all the grids here. It's actually not really required, but I'll set it to the lowest or the minimum grid size so that I can do a bit of measurement. Why don't we start with this little circle that is required right in the middle of this module? And I'll go ahead and add a pad, but let me go ahead and click Edit. And this is where I will go ahead and choose a non-plated through-hole mechanical because it is a mechanical hole, circular in size, and I'm going to position it 0 right in the origin. Position Y is also 0, and X in this case is the diameter, and this is where I'm going to put it as 3 mm. And once I place it, if you notice, it is right in the center. The next thing that we are going to do is draw the bounding box of the entire square. So this is a very squarish footprint. And for that too, we will not move it manually or use the grid. So we're going to make sure that we are in the front silkscreen layer. And I'm just going to start drawing, but I'm going to select it and hit E for edit. And this is exactly what I'm going to use to place the silkscreen lines precisely on the footprint. Now, before we go back to KiCad, I do want to mention a little bit about the grid system. So the X and the X axis is still similar in KiCad, but the Y axis, the negative portion is actually at the top. So it gets more and more negative as you go towards the top, and it goes more and more positive as you kind of go towards the bottom. So as you can see, the X axis should probably start at -5, and the Y should be +5.5 because it is coming down. So I'm going to put just that, -5, and the starting point of Y should be 5.5. Similarly, the end for the X will be +5, and the end for Y will be exactly the same. So once I hit OK, there you see the line is drawn precisely. Once again, I did not move it manually. I did not use the grid. Now I'm going to come back and draw the top one, and that is basically 4.5 millimeters minus for the Y axis. So for this, I'm going to select it and basically say duplicate it or Command D and give the coordinates accordingly. And there you see the two lines are drawn. So similarly, why don't we go ahead and draw the vertical line? So I'm just going to hit edit once again and put down the precise measurements. Oops, it is wrong. So let me go ahead and edit it once again. Yes, of course, the Y axis should be exactly the same. Now I'm going to duplicate it and hit edit and just move the X axis. So there you see the entire bounding box is done. Now the third step that I have for all of us is next, when we are going to create the actual pads on the footprint, we should always be using calculators to move it around. And KiCad provides the calculation function inbuilt. So this is actually a type of castellated edges. And there is a very, very cool article from SparkFun about creating castellated mounting holes. So what we are going to basically do is have these pads elongated on the front copper. So I'm going to first make sure that I'm on the front copper and then choose the add pad right here and then hit edit right away. So for this, it will be SMD and rectangular. And I'm going to put the pad number as 1. Let's first deal with the size X and size Y. So for X, we will have it as say 0.75 and have a little bit of elongation, so we will maybe just add 0.45 and make it 1.2, and for Y we will simply have it as 0.8. So this is the cool thing in KiCad, we can simply do the addition and subtraction right in the text box. Notice what happens when I click away, and now for size Y it will simply be 0.8. Next, let's fix the position X and position Y. If we come back to the data sheet, the position X will start with -5 because we are going to the left. But then we have to move a little bit further to the left because the position starts from the middle of the pad. And that's why I'm going to do 1.2, which is the entire length of the X, then divided by 2. And then finally adjust it by 0.75, which is how much it will move to the right. So now that we have this maths, once again, we do not have to have the calculated answer. We can come back to KiCad and place it in position X. And that will give us -4.85. Similarly, for position Y, it will be -4.5 because it is going towards the top. And we will centralize the position by dividing it by the dimension in the y-axis and then adjust it by a little bit of this position, 0.75. So now that we have these numbers, let's go back to KiCad and paste it. All right, so now that we have the position X and Y, let's click OK. And that's how it will look like. And now that we have the position of the first pad, we can go ahead and duplicate it for the rest of the 9 pads. And that should be really, really easy. Because all we need to do is select it and then Command D, edit it, and simply move the position Y. In this case, I'll just add on the mats right here. And of course, change the pad number to number 2 and drop it right there. Let's do the rest of the 3 pads. And once we have all the 5 pads on the left side, all we need to do is now duplicate it on the right side with the reflection in the x-axis. So for this, let me duplicate pad number 5 and hit edit 6. And all I need to do is in position X, I just need a positive number. That's it. And it will be right there. And similarly, we can do the reflection for the rest of the 4 pads. Command D, edit, make it pad number 7, positive, OK, and drop it there. And there you see we have all the 10 pads with just some mathematical equations that's coming right out of the text box inside KiCad. The next step that I tend to do is to use the other layers, typically not the copper layer or the silkscreen layer. They will be the courtyard layer or the comments layer, the drawings layer to put more information about the footprint. So let me go to the front courtyard layer, and this is where it will help us do some kind of bounding in the 3D dimension. So for this, definitely I will be using the grid. So maybe let me use the 5 mils grid. I think that should be good. And this one doesn't have to be too accurate. And that is why I'm not so precise about using the text boxes for placement. Similarly, I'll go to the back courtyard layer and then do a bounding box. I think the bounding box is only required around this hole because this is an SMD component. So once again, I do not have to be too accurate about this. So after this, we will come back to the front silkscreen layer and just ensure that we have some helpful notes for the user. And in this case, I'll definitely put the pin markings. So for example, pin 1. Now one thing you do notice that the silkscreen layer is actually overlapping with the copper layer, and this shouldn't be the case. So I'll go ahead and fix it. So I'm just going to put a break in the silkscreen layer like this. And now that I have fixed the silkscreen, I will put a little marking over here, right at the corner, to kind of indicate the placement. And the next step that I do in making these mechanical footprints from scratch is to do those final checks in lengths, whether they are matching up to the data sheet. And in KiCad, it is relatively easy with just the spacebar right at the bottom here, the DX and the DY. And once I press spacebar right now, it resets to 0. So this is exactly what we are going to use to cross-check the dimensions. For example, why don't we cross-check the dimension of one pad? The Y dimension is 0.8 and the X dimension from the edge of the footprint is actually 0.5. So I'm going to go exactly right here at number 10 pad. And I'm going to hit spacebar and notice how the DX and the DY over here changes all to 0. And when I scroll down, notice that DY is exactly 0.8 millimeters. Similarly, I'm going to come here right at the top and hit 0 or spacebar once again, and then come down all the way and notice that how it is 0.75, which is the exact measurement. And that's it. Hope you get to try out something that you design mechanically in a software and then get it out in the real world, in the physical world. And I'll see you in the next video. Thank you.